I'm going to show you how to make a monkey knuckle rainbow loom bracelet today. Example of what they look like, and you see if you stretch them out, they're called the monkey knuckle because they have all these little knuckles. You will need your loom facing with the arrow up. So now what you're going to do is you are going to take a white rubber band. Well, I choose white. You can do any color. And then you choose two colors. I'm going to be using red and purple. So you're going to take it and you are going to make a upside down triangle. And then make sure you're doing it with both colors that you choose. And then you're going to take your two colors again and you're going to overlap that in and then hook it onto the upper one so it actually does make a triangle. And it looks like, as you can see, it kind of looks like a diamond now. I understand that you're using two different colors. So you're going to take them again, stretch them out. And from that upper one at the point of the diamond-looking shape, you're going to make another upside-down triangle, just like that. And then you are going to take another of those two colors, see? And again, you're going to stretch them out, take it, and overlap it. So now we are going to make our last triangle. Again, you're going to make a kind of like a V shape, an upside down triangle. Take them and hook them on. And then you are going to continue this pattern all the way until this peg. Don't go any farther because we do something different at that point. Now, when you are done with your triangle pattern, when it ends at this peg, make sure you end it at that peg, the second last one, you are going to have your finished diamond. It has to have a point at the end like that. It can't be one of those flat ones, like one of those in the middle. So what you're going to do is you're just one single white rubber band and make a V upside down triangle. Then what you're going to do is you're going to flip your loom around, and this is the looming part. See, I flipped the loom around, and then what you're going to do is you're going to take this piece of your kit. Take the bottom circle part, flip it over one of these, and then you're just going to push all the rubber bands down. So the first step on your looming part is you're going to go in, grab those two, and hook them forward. And then now what you're going to do is there are two of the same color on this peg and that peg. So what you're going to do is you're going to reach under the top two, red and purple, and you're going to grab the bottom red and purple and bring them on there. And you're going to do the same thing on this side, grab the bottom two, red and purple, and hook them here. Now, on this first one, it will look a little different because it is the first one, but as you go up, you're going to be doing the same. Now what you're going to do is, since you have all these rubber bands, you're going to grab these two. So you're going to reach all the way under and grab those two. You have to really stretch the rubber bands out at this point. And then hook them forward. And then you're going to go in here. Same. And again, the bottom two. And then bottom two. Just like that. So again, you're going to grab these two rubber bands, reach under. Oh, grab the wrong ones. Go under.
Take them, hook them there. Bottom two, that top one, and again, bottom two. Repeat this pattern all the way to this peg. Repeat this pattern to this peg right here. Once you have done this pattern, since this peg right here, you're going to reach under these rubber bands, all these, and grab whatever color rubber band you have right here. In my case, it's the white. So, you're going, as I said, reach under and grab that and just hook it forward. Done doing this one, your pattern should look like this. Now, what you're going to do is on this last one, you're going to reach in, take any color of your band, and again, my case is the white, pull it through and hook it on. And pull it on to the thick part of your hook. Oh, it came off. Now, you are just going to rip. Sorry about that last part. My rainbow loom is broken. So, I'm just going to put this back in. Now, when your monkey knuckle bracelet is done, it should look like this. I have created this bracelet. It is my creation. Is carefully take those off, hook them on, and get a C clip.
I forgot where I put mine.
Oh, right here. Oh. Pull it up and hook those together, just like that. And then you're going to hook that side on and same thing, hook it on. So now you have your monkey knuckle bracelet. Thanks for watching my video on my creation of the monkey knuckle bracelet.